This was during a meeting between workers' representatives and trade unions, which was organized to revise strategies of reviving trade unions which are becoming too weak to stand the test of time. Workers expressed a need for labor unions to forge a memorandum of understanding with the ruling party NRM in order to enhance their visible voice of advocacy for labor rights.
In a memorandum of understanding with the political party that is sitting, that is when all these issues shall be solved. We shall now speak about roads, we shall speak about taxes, we shall speak about all these other things because we have a seat there.
Workers are concerned that the government has isolated trade unions and their voice no longer counts, which is threatening their existence. They believe it's no longer fashionable for labor unions to remain political when everything in the society is determined by politics.
Why do some constitutions of labor unions have that statement? How are we going to move ahead when we are apolitical? We are not associated with the politicians.
Workers MPs Arini Twe Rwakajara, Charles Wakabulindi and Margaret Rwabshaiza have pointed at bickering within members of trade unions as a key factor that has weakened workers' movements.
We are fighting each other. We are creating within ourselves this, that we are no longer strong.
Labor movement, we cannot defend ourselves if we don't invite allies.
Wakabulindi, however, cautions trade unionists to go slow with the idea of uniting with political parties, saying they need to first get organized, recruit a reasonable number of members for them to attract the attention of political parties.
I think when we are planning, let's now plan on how to strengthen our unions. Without that, there is no way.
Rwakajara, who organized the meeting, endorsed the idea of merging trade unions with political parties, saying the two formations mostly push for a similar agenda. He says this relationship between labor unions and political parties has worked in many countries.
So political parties, if we see they have a good agenda, they can respect workers' rights, we will work with them.
Trade unions in Uganda have existed since the 1930s. For much of Uganda's history, trade union activities have been greatly shaped by national politics and by events external to the country's labor movement. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.